Good morning, everyone, and welcome to Sunday School. My name is Chessie Breton, and I'm the Director of Children and Family Ministries here at Manchester United Methodist Church. I'm so excited you're here to join us for this wonderful season of Advent. Advent is a time of waiting as we prepare for Jesus' birth. Advent is the first four Sundays before Christmas. And so we are going to start today with our Advent Good Shepherd stories. Just a reminder to all of our friends and families that are joining us, and parents included, these stories all come with wondering questions. And again, don't answer them. Let our kiddos, our friends, be the ones to go through it. Wonder together. That is the fun part of these stories. As you go through the stories, don't forget that you can go to the Children and Family Ministry Facebook page to find activities and coloring pages that go along with the lessons. I look forward to learning more with you about Jesus' birth and all of Advent. As we go through, you will remember that we light candles. Sometimes when we talk about them, we light candles of hope and of love and of peace and of joy and, of course, the Christ candle. And my friends, I do want to let you know that just because we light those candles in a certain way for this series doesn't actually mean that that's how they're supposed to go. There is no right or wrong way to do it. Many times, though, you will notice that the first candle is hope. The third one, the pink one, is joy. And of course, the most important candle is the Christ candle, the last candle that we light on Christmas Eve and Christmas Day. I'm so excited to go on this journey with you. Have a wonderful Advent, and I'll see you soon. Goodbye.
Good morning and welcome to Sunday School. My name is Aiden Combs, and I'm a parent volunteer here at Manchester UMC. Today I get to tell you a wonderful story from the New Testament. We are in the season of Advent, which is a time we wait and prepare for the birth of Jesus Christ. All the words of this story are inside of me. If you make silence with me, I will find all the words to share the story of God's people with you. This cloth is purple because we are in a special time of waiting and getting ready. This time is called Advent. The people of God waited too. They didn't know that they were waiting for Jesus. They only knew they were waiting for the one God would send. This is a prophet. God sent prophets to the people of God to help them understand how to live while they were waiting. And when the people of God became sad because they had no Savior, the prophets spoke God's words of hope. One prophet named Isaiah said, "The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light." Without hope, it seems very dark, but with hope, there is light. The hope for a Savior, one who would save the people of God, made it feel very light for the people of God. During this first week of Advent, when we wait and get ready, we think of the prophets. And we light the prophet's candle of hope. So begins our celebration of Advent. We wait, as did all the people of God, for the birth of a Savior. You know, I wonder what one light is like in all darkness. I wonder how you walk in all darkness. I wonder how the prophet's voice sounded. I have another series of questions I wonder about for you older children. In this story, we talked about the prophet who said the words of God to God's people. Can you think of someone who is like a prophet today? When you say or show how to live as a Christian, are you being a prophet to your friends? Why or why not? And lastly, I wonder. We read Isaiah 9, 1 through 7. The time period of this part of Isaiah is approximately 600 years or more before the birth of Jesus. Did you think Isaiah was saying in this verse that a baby would be born to a woman named Mary? If so, why? If not, what do you think he may have been thinking about? The story from Isaiah comes from a time when some of the people of God has been destroyed by the Assyrians. It was a very dark time for them. What kind of king would these people be hoping for? When you read Isaiah 9, 1 through 7, which Old Testament king is mentioned in the description of the one who would save the people of God? Children of God, it's time for us to change our light. If we leave our light like this, it makes the spot in front of us very bright, but it can't go anywhere else. But if we change our light, then in a different way, our light can go everywhere. Thank you for joining me for today's Good Shepherd story about the prophet and the first week of Advent. If you want to learn more about our story today, visit the Manchester Children and Family Ministries Facebook page for additional activities and coloring pages. Thank you so much and have a great week. Goodbye.